Dearly beloved, my loving greetings to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Our Lord God has granted me grace to speak to you from this hill station of Kodaikanal. Do you see beautiful flowers blooming here? You all eat potato, right? This is a potato field. You're under the soil, you can find potatoes. Today, let me read to you a scripture. When we turn to the Bible, in Proverbs chapter 3 and verse 6, in all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your paths. The Lord will direct your paths. Only when the path is straight, we can walk properly. Am I right? Many years ago, we used to go to the hilly area of Yerkadu and stay in an estate to preach the gospel to the tribal people over there. This happened when I was studying in the Bible college, that is maybe before 45 years. We used to start in the evening time as a team of 10 to 15. There would be grass and bushes all over the way. We would stand wondering how to walk in that path. We wouldn't know. It was grassy everywhere, but only if we had walked that path, we could reach the village on that hill. There was a friend, a brother who was working in the estate. He would bring a bill hook and go before us, cutting all the grass and making way. After he had made way, we would walk very easily in that path. Likewise, we stumble in our lives sometimes wondering how to proceed. There may be problems of unemployment, studies, with the life of the children or finance. How to walk with all these problems? We can't see the way, we may stumble without knowing what to do. But the Word of God says, in all your ways acknowledge Him and He shall direct your paths. Let me repeat, in all your ways acknowledge Him and He shall direct your paths. He will go before you and tell you, my son, my daughter, you must come like this. He will direct our paths for us to walk. Then you can walk easily. There will be no more hurdles. If you have to walk in a path that is full of grass and bushes, you may have fear of snakes and other things as well. But when He comes, He will clear up and make way for us. The Lord does so. We need to acknowledge the Lord in our ways. We need to acknowledge the Lord in each and everything. What is meant by acknowledging the Lord in everything? Every day, as soon as you wake up in the morning, you need to make every matter of that particular day known to the Lord. When I pray early in the morning, I will list out what all I must do that day. I must go to the office and do all this, take decisions in these particular things. Oh Lord, help me. Today I must record so many messages. Help me. I must take a decision in this matter today. Show me what I must do. When I had listed out each and everything in the presence of God and prayed, I could see the Lord directing all my paths and guiding me beautifully. So we must acknowledge the Lord in our ways. We need to have a practice of keeping the Lord before us and doing things. Would you do like that? Think and see. Why are you not able to walk properly? Why do you stumble all the time? Why are you confused and not able to move forward? Because the path in the front is not good. Should you not make this known to the Lord? Should you not commit your way to Him? Only then He can direct your path. Is that right? Will you tell today, dear Lord, I will acknowledge you in all my ways. Please direct my paths. So let us pray. Dear Father, thank you for you are the God who directs our paths and guides us beautifully and safely. We commit ourselves to acknowledge you in all our ways. We surrender ourselves to think of you in each and every matter. We commit ourselves and pray in the name of Jesus Christ, dear Father. Amen. Amen.